When dealing with late effects for past decades, I was often wondering how the small country like Holland can produce so many and so prominent papers on this issue and different papers. And there are, of course, several answers, but one of the answers must be Flora van Leeuwen, our next speaker, who is head of the Department of Epidemiology in the Netherlands Cancer Institute, and she has, as far as I know, dealt with those problems last two decades and made very prominent contributions to the issues. Please, Flora, you will talk about risk of breast cancer after cancer in childhood and adolescence. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Stanislav. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would also like to start by thanking the organizers for inviting me. Hamish, you really did a great job getting bringing us all together here. It's a great pleasure to be here, first time in Scotland. Well, breast cancer, as you already heard from Sandy, is an exceedingly important problem in survivors of childhood cancer and adolescent cancer. So in the next half hour or so, I will review the available evidence for you. I have structured my talk as follows. First, I will discuss the magnitude of the risk increase because there are differences in the reported risks. Next, does the risk increase or decrease with longer follow-up? What are the treatment-related risk factors? Of course, I'm going to discuss radiation dose and volume and chemotherapy, hormonal risk factors, and family history and genes. Then I get to preventive measures, and finally, I'll mention a couple of unresolved issues.